our hope, amen. Nothing will change if all the plans I make go wrong. Your love stays the same. Your light will guide me through it all. I'm hanging on, I'm leaning into you. Nothing can reach the end of all your faithfulness. Your grace goes with me through every shadow, every test. I'm hanging on, I'm leaning in. I don't know where you'll take me, but I know you're always good. My hope is built on nothing less than your great love, your righteousness. I will not walk another way. I trust your heart, I trust your name. Change if all the plans I make go wrong. Your love stays the same. Your light will guide me through it all. I'm hanging on, I'm leaning into you. Nothing can reach the end of all your faithfulness. Your grace goes with me through every shadow, every test. I'm hanging on, I'm leaning into you. Yes, Lord. I don't know where you'll take me, but I know you're always good. My hope is built on nothing less than your great love, righteousness. I will not walk another way. I trust your heart, I trust your name. I'm holding on, I'm holding on to you. You are my rock when storms are raging all around. Shelter me, God. I'm safe with you on solid ground. I'm hanging on, I'm leaning in to you. I don't know where you'll take me, but I know you're always good. My hope is built on nothing less than your great love, your righteousness. I will not walk another way. I trust your heart, I trust your name. I'm holding on, I'm holding on to you. My hope is built on nothing less than your great love, your righteousness. I will not walk another way. I trust your heart, I trust your name. I trust your heart, I trust your name. I trust your heart, I trust your name. I'm holding on.
I want to address you, the worship team. These guys aren't worship team. You're the worship team. And we're, our Father is the audience. And so I want you to express, as we worship to the Lord, a freedom of being able to, if you have a scripture, if God's leading you at some point, come on up to me, and we want to be worshiped together, and we'll share with one another. We are the worshipers. You represent a priesthood. We come together. It's not coming and looking at a performance. These guys should, a curtain could be in front of them. It's not about a performance. It's about us with our hearts joining in and going into the throne room of God and letting your, that inner man, being able to intercede with Papa, with Daddy, and worshiping His holy name. So, Father, we just want to enter into Your presence, Lord. We ask that You, Jesus, would hear our prayers and intercede before the Father for us. And, Lord, would our prayers go up as incense into the throne room. And we ask for a cloud of glory to come, Lord. The glory of the prayers of the saints, the glory of who You are, that You just shower down upon us. And we ask for Your anointing to just flow in the room, Lord. And so, Father, we ask that You would receive all of us as worshipers to You. And we pray this in Jesus' precious name.
He's jealous over us with His love, amen.
Don't have time to maintain these regrets when I portion, and we are his portion, and he is our prize, drawn to redemption by the grace in his eyes. If grace is an ocean, we're all sinking. And heaven meets earth like sloppy white kissing. My heart turns violently inside of my chest.
One day Satan came along, and Satan said, "You can eat that tree, you'll become like God, you know good from evil." And they ate of it. They forgot who they were. God told them that I created you in the image, in my image. All that I have is all yours. Do we sometimes forget who we are? John 1:12 says we are sons and daughters of God if we believe in him. So we are his beloved.
Yeah.
And we don't need to forget that. We need to remember that. And just listen to this music this morning. I hear that we love God. And we praise the Lord for that. So we are his beloved. Hallelujah. Yeah. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God.
God is telling me that He wants us to get out of the sea in the natural. He wants to see us to see through spiritual eyes. He wants us to see through one lens. That's the love of Jesus Christ. And we thank him for what he did on that cross. Can somebody give a shout of praise to Jesus today? Can somebody give a shout of praise of what he's doing in Elmira, New York today? Oh, thank you, Lord. Like John said, in Jericho, when they brought the worshipers and the warriors to take down them walls, that's us, church. That's us. Elmira is our land of milk and honey. It's right here for the taking. We just got to take it. Take down them walls of oppression. Take down them walls of addiction. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
Oh,
Just soak in his love for you. Soak in that love right now. Keep going, keep going. Just let the music play in your heart and let the theme of how he loves me. Soak it in, church. God so loved me that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. For God so loved me. Can you say that? For God so loved me. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you for loving me. You may be seated. If you guys can just kind of keep playing softly, appreciate that. Let's prepare our hearts for communion. As we commune with God and he with you. This is our Valentine dinner with Jesus. So let's just keep in that frame of candlelight. Of you communing with the one you love, your first love. So many times we say God loves you and he does love you, but it's so much harder to say God loves me. And because we're told, well, that's prideful, and that we get this kind of weird thing that we don't accept his, and all of a sudden everything we're doing out of obligation. We're doing out of different reasons than God loves me. 1 John 3:16 says this, and I'm going to read it in the first person. The first person means what? Me. And a lot of times when we read scripture, I like to put, instead of it saying you, I put me in there in my name, because then it's more personal. And I'll read it that way, 1 John 3:16 through 18. It says, this is how I know that what love is. This is how I know what love is. Jesus Christ laid down his life for me, and I ought to lay down my life for my brothers and sisters. If anyone has material possessions, or I should say, if I have material possessions and see my brother or my sister in need, but I have no pity on them, how can the love of God be in me? See, that places the burden on my shoulders. It's not, well, if the church sees a burden and they don't make need for that, then, gee, the church doesn't have the love. No, it's that if I know what love is and I see someone and my brother and sister in need and I have material possessions, but I don't do anything with that, then the love of God, how can it really be in me? And I think many times, dear children, that we love with blinders on. And it says, dear children, let us not love with words or speech, but with actions in truth. And the truth that it's talking about is that for God so loved me that now I can love others. In 1 John 4:7 through 12, it says, dear friends, let us love one another. For the love that comes from God, everyone who has been born of God and knows God, whoever does not love does not know God, because God is love. And this is how God showed his love among us, that he sent his one and only Son into the world. And here I go first person again, that I might live through him. Who might live through him? I might live through him. And this is love, that I love God. Not that I loved God, but that God loved me. And he sent his Son as an atoning sacrifice for my sins. Dear friends, since God has so loved you, also you ought to love one another. Not that no one has ever seen God. No one has ever seen God, but if we love one another, God, and God lives in us, then his love is made complete in us all. As we take communion this morning, we look at the price, and the purpose is we look at the price that Jesus paid for our salvation, don't we? And it's very important, but it doesn't just end with our salvation. It begins there with our salvation. Jesus did so much more when he died on that cross, because he provided for us a new covenant. It's a covenant of relationships that now we have with our Heavenly Father. God the Father and God the Son and God the Holy Spirit has made covenant between us, between one another. And all this is powered by his agape love, for God so loved, God so loved, God so agape'd us that he gave his only Son. What is that love? It's unconditional love. In fact, I hate to even use the word love, because in when you look at the original Greek word, it's not love, it's agape, and we trans, you know, we make it into love, but it's a whole different love. It's a love that has no conditions to it. So we love without anything expected back, and how someone treats me back has no bearing on my how I treat them, because I treat them out of agape. And I don't expect, agape doesn't expect anything in return. Only when we receive the grace of God can we live out this agape, this covenant relationship. And so when we come to communion, what does that communion all mean? It's that we remind ourselves, we reevaluate ourselves in the purpose of covenant. When we come before, we just don't go through the motions. Yeah, God forgave me. No, he did so much more than that. He brought you into a covenant. Well, what does that mean? Covenant means this, church. All that is mine is yours. And all that is yours is mine. I think of Howard McHenry. He's sick today, but we've said to each other, anything you need, just go in my garage and get any tool, any saw, anything. I don't have to worry. He can just come and take anything he wants. If he wants my tractor, he can take it. He can take anything, any of my possessions. It doesn't matter. Just come and take it. And he does the same. I can go in his garage and fill up my truck full of things. It doesn't matter, because we're in a covenant relationship. We trust each other. You know, we're in that covenant relationship. Now, don't take one of my hunting guns. I might have an issue with that. No, just kidding. But covenant means that all that is mine is yours. And that means that everything I have really with an open hand. And everything that is yours is mine. Well, how is that played out? I believe that's played out in how it looks, is that the two become one. And what's the greatest example of the two become one? We see today in marriage. When I do marriage counseling, I stress the importance that it's a marriage being of covenant relationship to one another. In a covenant, you give yourself to the other person. Marriage should not be of what I get out of it, but what I give into it. And so there's a giving. And in that giving, the secret and the greatest thing, that in a giving, you always receive back so much more than what you can give. And that's what Jesus established on the cross. He gave. He died for you. He died for me. He died for me. Can you say that out loud with me? He died for me. For me. Wow. And there's a revelation of truth that all of us need to come to, and that's Jesus loves me. He gave to me the highest gift of saving my life. He saved my life. And now out of love, I'm just indebted. I just give everything I can back to him. Oh, how he loves me. Oh, how he loves you. He died for me. He took my sin, my shame, my guilt, all the bad, all the mistakes, all the things, all my nature. He took it all on that cross. And it buried with him. And now I live in newness of life. I've been born again. And now I receive his healing, his adoption as his son. I receive sonship. And there's an acceptance because of agape love. His agape love is, I can never do anything to turn him. You know, it's just like my children. I can be disappointed, but I'll never turn my back on them because I love them. And I don't expect back from them because I love them. Whatever they do, I'll get over it because I love them so much. And that's what God has done for you through Jesus. Why do we need this revelation from God of really understanding sonship, understanding covenant? It's because we can't love others until we've learned to really love ourselves. Well, what does that mean? When we love ourselves, we understand that because God so loved me and I've accepted that, out of that love and that expression is an outpouring that I'm able to love others. And I find my identity in my father, my dad. I find my identity there, not in what other people say, not in what expectations, peer pressures, or what television or media says. I find my identity in my Father. And I have a fullness of that revelation. And out of that revelation is an overflow that I can serve and love others. And then I become a human being, not a human doing. So as we come into a time of communion, would you just reflect how he loves you? And would you come to a communion at a time of just expressing yourself out of that covenant? Maybe you want to just recommit that life to him, saying, Lord, I want to live out of covenant with you. I want to live out of the love that you have for me. Because of what you did on the cross. And then it frees you up to go on the journey with Jesus, to do so many things for other people, going into the ministry that God has for you. All the other stuff that happens is an overflow out of the relationship first of with Papa Dad. Papa. So Father, would the elders please come up and let's just prepare our hearts for communion. So much more I could say on this, but Mickey is going to be sharing with us this morning and excited to hear what God is going to say. But Father, as we come in time of communion, Lord, we just express our love for you, and we just again reunite that covenant of love that you have for us and what you did on the cross. Now, everything I have is yours, and everything that is yours is mine. because you love me. And so, Lord, just receive our act of worship this morning as we time of communing with you. In Jesus' name, amen. So as you feel led and we'll just continue to worship the Lord, just continue your own heart to worship the Lord and come and just receive of the covenant cup and the bread this morning of what Jesus did on the cross. You may stand.
Thank you, Father. We thank you for the grace, the mercy we were exposed to in Christ Jesus. And our tradition here at Southside, God, we take of the elements on our own. But I want to, as we've received, Father, and maybe some still even praying, I want to declare this word over all of us. For I received from the Lord what I also passed on to you. The Lord Jesus, on the night that he was betrayed, took bread. When he had given thanks, he broke it and said, "This is my body, which is for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood. Do this whenever you drink it in remembrance of me." Would you pray with me? Father, if we do not take of this great gift, this broken body, this poured out blood, we can have no part of you. And so, in our journeys today, God, Would you stir us in such a way to say yes to the fullness and the full measure, as Pastor John was saying, of your poured out love? We need you. We want you. We may not even know all of what that means. And that's okay. We're looking for truth. We're looking for peace. And we thank you, God, for showing that to us today in new and deeper ways. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen.
Indescribable, uncontainable, you place the stars in the sky. You know them by name. You are amazing, God. All powerful, untamable, awestruck, we fall to our knees as we humbly proclaim, you are amazing, God. From the highest, of heights to the depths of the sea, creation's revealing your majesty. From the colors of fall to the fragrance of spring, every creature unique in the song that it sings, all exclaiming, indescribable, uncontainable, you place the stars in the sky and you know them by name. You are amazing, God. All powerful, untamable, awestruck, we fall to our knees as we humbly proclaim, you are amazing, God. Who has told every lightning bolt where it should go, or seen heavenly storehouses laden with snow? Sun and gave source to its light that conceals it to bring us the coolness of night. None can fathom, indescribable, uncontainable, you place the stars in the sky and we know them by name. You are amazing, God. Untamable, awestruck, we fall to our knees as we humbly proclaim, you are amazing, God. Indescribable, uncontainable, you place the stars in the sky and you know them by name. You are amazing, God. He's incomparable. Incomparable, unchangeable, you see the depths of my heart and you love me the same. You are amazing, God. Let's sing that last part again. Incomparable, unchangeable, you see the depths of my heart and you love me the same. You are amazing.
We're going to continue to just have a time to worship. Man's good with that. We'll worship some more. But we want to leave this space open for you. Sometimes when you're stirred up to take a step, it's like using a muscle you haven't used in a long time. You understand what I'm saying? Sometimes the fear of something so simple, and whether it's about writing a picture or a word, there's still these thoughts that creep into our minds like, you can't draw. You understand? You understand what I'm saying? Because some of you, there's this thing that's going saying, you can't draw.
the enemy has been speaking lies to you about the creative power that you hold because you were formed in your Father's image. And he is the eternal, self-sufficient one. So I'm going to push you past that fear in Jesus' name. Don't be afraid. Don't be timid. Go for it. God will meet you where you're at, okay? But see, that's the thing that we believe, the thing that we don't possess the fullness of our Father's image. We actually don't look like him. And he's saying, no, you look just like me. Isn't that good? So we're going to keep worshiping. Just open time, whatever that means, meet with the Lord, write a picture. But if that's what you're thinking this morning, I'm going to charge you to push past that. God wants you to hear what his word over your life is. As a child with faith would receive the truth that their father speaks over them, they would simply say, yes, Dad, I believe you. I believe you, and I'm not going to be afraid because our Father says so. And that's enough. That's enough. You don't need another word. You just need his word. So we'll continue to worship. You are so loved today. Not because I'm saying so or Mickey Pastor, but because God so loved you that he gave his son. That's why. May you enjoy him this week. Enjoy him as you go. Stay in worship. Write something, a word, a picture, whatever you want to do. Hang out. Have some fellowship. Say hi to someone you haven't seen in a few days. But we bless you in Jesus' name to have the week that God intends for you.
As we humbly proclaim, you are amazing.